So believers in the supernatural often have profoundly unusual experiences that they describe as transcendent or otherworldly. Consider, for example, the biblical story of Saul's experience of heavenly lights and the voice of Jesus on the road to Damascus, or the Quran's accounts of Muhammad's many encounters with the angel Gabriel. Nor are these kinds of experiences limited to those described in sacred texts. Even a quick search of the internet will yield dozens of sites dedicated to reports of encounters with angels, demons, Jesus, or even God himself. Now, if you want to understand religious belief, it's crucial to understand these sorts of profound experiences. The development of new research tools and some clever adaptations of old ones have allowed cognitive scientists to probe the nature of these experiences in recent years. So, for example, the ancient Greeks called epilepsy the sacred disease because epileptics so often described their experiences during seizures in mystical terms. Today, we understand very well the chaotic, uncontrolled spiking activity that occurs in neural circuits that gives rise to these states. And we also understand that one of the most frequent foci of these seizures is a large region of the brain known as the temporal lobe. Now, this is a region of the brain heavily involved in things like face recognition and speech processing, as well as memory for time and place. So if you disturb this region, it's not surprising that it gives rise to experiences of faces, voices, and disturbances in your sense of time and location. Or consider the study of what happens in the brain during deep meditation or prayer. Many of these studies have been done using new scanning techniques, like PET scans, SPECT scans, and so on. And people report their experience of these states as involving a loss of sense of self, a feeling of disconnection from their ordinary sensory experience of the world. And what we see in the scans of the brain during these states is a decline in the amount of activity in the right parietal region, which is an essential brain region for tracking our sense of having a physical body at all that exists at a particular location in space. Even more dramatic is the finding that very strong magnetic stimulation of the brain, transmagnetic stimulation, or TMS it's sometimes called, which disrupts normal patterns of electrical activity, causes people to have out-of-body experiences or to feel that they're in the presence of something or someone transcendent or supernatural. Now, this doesn't mean that these localized brain changes are the whole story about religious belief. A surprisingly large portion of the population, somewhere between a third and a half, has had one or more of these experiences, yet only some people describe them in religious terms. It seems that whether these experiences are described as religious or not depends on what you already believe. So those who don't believe in the reality of the supernatural do not tend to experience these states as having religious significance. Furthermore, whether the religious experience you do have, if you have one, is taken to be an experience of, say, Jesus or Vishnu, depends on whether you believe in Jesus or Vishnu to begin with. Now, it's important to remember that the partial understanding we do have may well seem unappealing to the true believer for whom these beliefs have profound personal meaning. But precisely because our beliefs about such matters are so important to us, both as individuals and as members of cultures and nations, it's vital that we continue the effort to understand them.